You are welcome in the video tutorial of image classification, and in this video we will talk about that what is image classification and what is the workflow. We'll discuss in detail that step by step, and this down is something about me. I'm Dr. Zubairul Islam. I'm working in the Department of Geography, Adigrat University, Ethiopia. So image classification refers to the task of extracting information classes from the multi-band raster image. And this multi-band raster image can be the true color image, it can be false color image, and it can be a principal component analyzed image. So what happens, suppose if this is a true color image, in the true color image you can visualize that this is the forest, this is the water, this is the, you know, the agriculture area, this is the grassland area, this is built up area. So what you have to do, you have to mark that this is here, this land class. So based on there are two ways of classification, we'll discuss in the next slide, but with the help of true color image, what we are doing, we are extracting the information. Okay, so the resulting raster from image classification can be used to create the thematic maps. Theme may be any. It may be land use land class map. It can be the agricultural map. It can be the something related to the grassland area and another. So depending on the interaction between the analyst and the computer during classification, you know, there are two types of classification. One is supervised classification and another is unsupervised classification. So supervised classification uses the spectral signature obtained from the training samples to classify an image. Here see the word supervised. Supervised means what? Supervision, under your supervision. If you are doing the classification, then you will tell to this, you will give the information to the computer that this is the grassland area, this is the water area, this is the forest area. Then based on the information given by you in the form of signatures, the software will classify your image into different classes. So we'll do it with the help of software. Another is unsupervised classification. Unsupervised classification find spectral classes in a multi-band image without the analyst intervention. We will give the number of classes and software will divide, will classify the image. Suppose we are giving 5 classes, the software will make the ISO cluster, and therefore thereafter based on the ISO cluster it will classify the image. So the next is image classification workflow. So here this is the detailed steps given for image classification workflow. This workflow is divided into 10 parts. The first part is, of course, you have to see your data, you have to explore the data. And if there is some pre-processing required, you will go for it. So once you have explored your data and your data is perfect and ready to for classification, then you decide that whether I will go for supervised or unsupervised. Basic differences: supervised classification, supervision yours. You will supervise that this is the grassland, this is the forest, this is so on and so forth. But in unsupervised classification, just you have to give the number of classes, thereafter software will do the classification. If you are working with the supervised classification, second is collecting training samples. Of course, you have to collect and you have to give the information that this is grassland, this is water. Thereafter, you will evaluate the training samples, and number third. And the fourth is editing training samples if it is required, then creating the signature file. Then this file is important. When you are doing the supervised classification, there is a need of a signature file. So once you have created the signature file, then you can work on that supervised classification part. You will examine the signature file, then editing the signature file, then applying the classification thereafter, post-classification processing. So in this video, we will cover first to nine. And in the next video, we'll talk about the post-classification processing, because this post-classification processing is it's a little longer process. So in this video, we'll cover first to nine. So under the data exploration and pre-processing, first we will talk the data exploration here. So before I start, let me introduce my data. This data belongs to the Adigrat town in Tigray region, and this data has 5 bands, and this time this is the true color image. If you want, you can see this is true color image. If you want false color, then you can see here false color image. So you can see the red area is showing you the vegetation, and the cyan color is showing you the built up area. Okay, and the first thing is data exploration. You know, the classification analysis is based on the assumption. There is an assumption, remember, that the band data, this is the band data and training samples, which we will collect later, both follow the normal distribution. This is the assumption. So when you are taking the samples, you have to take care that your sample should follow the, you know, the normal distribution. Means there should not be biased training sample. You have taken less training samples for one class, and another class you have taken more samples. So if you will do like that, then your classification can be biased. So to check the distribution of the data in a band, use the interactive histogram tool, which is given in the spatial analyst toolbar. Where is the spatial analyst toolbar? You will right click and you will take from here. This is the spatial analyst toolbar. So this toolbar is means the buttons are not highlighted. Why? Because this is in combination. This image is in combination. And there should be a single band for that. Let's make stretch it, and this is the band number one. And when you will see the band number one, once you have taken the only one band, then you can see the histogram here. This is the histogram, which is more or less normal distributed. The only thing is the tail is more towards the right hand side from the mean here. So this is you can see the band 1. Similarly, you can see band 2 also, band 2, and you can see the histogram. This is for band 2. So here, in the same way, you can explore your data with the help of this tool. And to check the distribution of individual training samples, we can use the histogram tool, which is given on the training sample manager. That we will do later. So the second is stretching of band data. So the value range from each band should be similar. Okay, if the value range is of one band is too small relative to the other band, you can use the mathematical tool, which is given in the spatial analyst toolbox, to stretch it. For example, you can use the times mat tool to multiply the bands with a constant value to stretch this value trench. So this was about the stretching of band data. And the third one is the principal component analysis, which I have prepared a separate video for this. You can watch if you want to know in detail about the principal component analysis. Principal component analysis, it transforms a multi-band image to remove the correlation among the bands. Means those values which are repeating among the bands is eliminated, and only the useful information is added in the principal component analysis. So the information in the output image is mainly concentrated in the first few bands. Okay, so by enhancing the first few bands, more details can be seen in the image when it is displayed in the ArcMap. This could be very helpful for collecting training samples. So the principal components tool for the multivariate toolset allows you to perform principal component analysis. Let's see here, I am repeating it again. Just you can make the RGB composite here, 432. Thereafter apply it. Okay, then you can go for principal component analysis. That is given in multivariate here, principal components. Okay, so what is the, how a principal component will give you more information? This is the purpose. It will highlight the information here. Number of principal components are by default 5 because I have 5 bands. I will do it 3, then do it okay. Then you can observe by yourself. See, have a look on this image. How many classes are visible? Okay, this is visible here. This is built up area. This is some another area in brown color. In white color looks like a barren land. In dark red looks like agriculture land here. And now you see it has distinguished. Now it is discriminated from one class to another class. Okay, if you will see within built-up area, you will find that easily you can see, okay, this is some orange color. So, but here there is no orange color, but it is giving you the information. This is blue color here. This is blue color. And this color is showing you the vegetation, more vegetation. So it has taken the information probably from the near infrared fifth band. So this is the vegetation area. So principal component analysis can help you in collecting the sample points better. Then the next is creating a multi-band image. The image classification toolbar works with the multi-band layers. So to load individual band to a new multi-band image, use the composite bands. Band composition, you can, if you have the individual bands in your table of content, you can go to the window, you can go to the image analysis. You will select your individual bands here. By unselecting another bands, you will select the individual bands, and thereafter you will click on this band combination, this button here. It will be highlighted if you are having the individual bands. Okay, yeah, like this it will be highlighted. But here, because these are already multi-band bands, so I'm not going to do this. Okay, the next is if you are having 5 band, 6 band, multi-band image, and if you want only few bands, not all bands, then what you will do, you will go for that very purpose, you will go to the data management tool. then layers and table views, then make raster layer. And here suppose this is 5 bands here, and you need only 3 bands. You need 2, 3, 4. You need only these 3 bands, then you will do it okay here. Then an image will be created which will give you only these 3 bands. So you can see here you have got a 3 band image. Okay, this is 4, this is 3, this is 2. Okay, then you can create the true color image like this. So but here this is the 432 true color image, and we have done the data exploration in data pre-processing. If you are having the data which is not corrected geometrically, and if you have the GPS points, so with the help of those GPS point, and if you have the dam, so with the help of GPS point and dam, you can make some geo corrections also in your image before analysis. Landsat is also giving you the level 1 data which is already geometrically corrected, which I'm using here. So this is all about the data exploration and pre-processing, image pre-processing. So now we'll talk about the collecting training samples. And in supervised classification, training samples are used to identify classes and calculate their signature. So training samples can be created interactively using the training samples drawing tool on the image classification toolbar. So first let's take the image classification toolbar here. This is our image classification toolbar. So creating a training sample is similar as you are doing some drawing in the draw toolbar with graphics. The NARC map accept the training samples shapes are managed with training sample manager. Training sample manager, you see here, click training sample manager. So to create the training sample, select one of the training sample drawing tool. Okay, so to create the signatures, this is the draw tool. If you will click here, you will find different options. You can choose the rectangle. Here I'm choosing the polygon. So as you can see that this is the built-up area. When you are choosing the samples, be careful. It should not be like this because it will take another class. So this is for, if you want to merge, select both, merge it. You can split also. When you will click, it will again split. So here this is the way how you can merge. This is what built up area. I'm writing in short here. You can give it value 1. Then again you will choose the forest area, not forest, but we can call it the vegetation, green vegetation area. This is the area where green vegetation is there. So we will take like this, we'll merge it, make it vegetation. There is some area which you can call like bushland area, maybe. So we can. Okay. This is okay. This red color actually it is showing some agriculture area, bushland area. So because whatever you know classes are you are giving, it is very important to give the correct classes. So better you visit the area and you see that what exactly is this. I don't know what is this, but I think this is the bushland area. So I'm writing here bush. I don't know what is this. Bushland. Here, this is some sort of the barren area. Barren. So we can give the values for 1. Just to make the differences. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, you have done it and you have collected the samples. Next, to evaluate your samples, what you will do, you will select 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can see in numerical way. Like this is the statistics of built-up area, vegetation area, bushland, and barren area. So this is the way you can evaluate your samples. Similarly, you can see the scatter plots also of in two different bands. So as you can see here, built-up area is giving you the higher values here. Actually, we should go classification after this some kind of corrections like we're changing the DN values to the reflectance. But here my purpose is to go for the classes, image classes workflow. So in the next video, I will talk about how we can change the DN values to the reflectance. But here, I just want to show you the classes, the workflow for image classes. Then you can see the histograms also here. So as you can see the vegetation here, this is band 5. Why the vegetation is giving you higher values? Because this is near infrared bands and NIR band gives you more values in the vegetated areas. So after doing all this, okay, what you will do now, you will create the signature files. You can give the name of your signature file like maybe I'm giving here PG or Adigrat. This is the signature file saved. Okay, if you want to save it as a shape file, then you can save it from here, and it is very highly advisable because what you can do is you can use the same samples again and again. And suppose I have cleared the sample, and thereafter I want to load, then I can load from here. I can load again. And if I want to change something in the vegetation, I will click and split. So this is what vegetation. So if by mistake I have given something wrong here, then I can remove from, I can delete from here, and I can give another sample like this vegetation area. So now I will select these three and I will merge it, and it will be merged to the vegetation. Then I will save it to AST. Okay, so this is the way you can modify to make your classification more accurate again and again. When you are collecting the samples, you can use this principal component analysis. It will give you more details about the data. So you have done it. Thereafter, what you will do? So you have already created the signature file. Now you are ready to, you can remove from here the classes and you can close it. And you are ready to apply these signatures. Okay, you have given the signature. So for that, you will click the maximum likelihood classification given under the multivariate toolset, and you will give your data here. Remember, you have to give your data correct. Thereafter, you will give the signature file where you have saved the signature file by the name of AD here. Open it. And thereafter you will do it okay. So now you can see here your classes. The classes are there. The first one, what you can do, you can change, you can give the name. The first class was, as you remember, this was built up area. And second was the vegetation area. Third was the bushland area, bush. And here, this was the barren area. So built up area, you can give some building color. This is vegetation area, you can give some green color. Bushland area, you can give some light color. And barren area, you can save some another color. So like this you can do your classification. Your classification is done here. So we have got a very good image, and you know, if you want, you can classify the, here this is the source, pixel size is 30 30. I want the area of each of my class, then I know the pixel counts here. What I will do, I will calculate the area, double okay. So you will go to field calculator, the yes, then count time, sorry, count times 30 times 30. So this area will come in square meter. Okay, if you want to change, you can make it in square kilometer by, like this is the around 12 square kilometer area. The first one, the built up area here. So you can see this is 12 kilometer, but I calculated in square meter. You want, then you can divide it by 1 million, then it will convert it into a square kilometer. (Clears throat) this is the way you can go for classification, and here you can take it into layout, and you can write a digraph, and you can give the legend north scale, and your classification work is done then. There is one important thing which is I want to tell you is, because here I didn't convert my bands from DN to reflectance, and that is must before you go for classification. And I have prepared already, and you can find that video how to convert from DN to reflectance in my another videos. And the purpose of making this video was to introduce you the flow, the workflow, how you take step by step your classification. So it's enough for now. Thanks for watching, dear. Thanks for listening.